All right, AIMIM chief Asauddin Owaisi is hit out, says this is the second case of death in a judicial custody. The family had expressed doubts that he would be killed in prison. Family says he was given slow poison. The government of Uttar Pradesh said his life is going to be protected, his family told. And when he was taken from jail to the hospital, concern was not a doctor. Then from where he was sent back to jail, there should be an independent investigation.
जाएगा कि कोई अंदर आएगा और फिर सुप्रीम कोर्ट को उत्तर प्रदेश की सरकार ने ये बताया कि उनकी हिफाजत की जाएगी उनकी जान की जिससे उनकी मौत वाकई में हुई है तो मैं ये चाहूंगा कि इसकी एक सही तरीके से इंडिपेंडेंट इंक्वायरी हो ये दूसरा ऐसा वाकया हम देख रहे हैं कि कन्विक्टेड प्रिजनर को जुडिशियल कस्टडी में उनकी मौत हुई है
Abhishek Mishra getting asked more details as far as political statements on this is concerned. Many have raised concerns that there have been extrajudicial killings and this could be one of them. The family was already afraid and that this should be probed.
Well, certainly, Sneha, and with now Asauddin Owaisi coming out and speaking very openly about it is a clear indication that the opposition, one by one, is united on at least this front. Congress has also already spoken about having an investigation. Samajwadi Party leaders have also reflected the same. And now Asauddin Owaisi, AIMIM chief, is clearly saying that the family is claiming slow poisoning is the cause of death, an inquiry should be done independently. He also said that he died in judicial custody and where is politics in it. Also that state is run by the gun, not by the rule of law. That is a big allegation he has made on the Yogi Adityanath government, and also said that the Hope state government will conduct impartial inquiry. Now, we have also seen how there are no satisfaction from the family's side. They've demanded for a postmortem through doctors of AIIMS, but it is unlikely for now that that will be heard. We got to know that the preparations are being made to bring the body to Ghazipur, where we are right now. So that process has begun. The postmortem has already been concluded. The official paperwork is happening. So this is what we can expect. But all these political reactions which are coming in this particular case is a clear indication that the opposition is not leaving any opportunity to question this whole case. How did it happen? Why did it happen? Under the circumstances and even with the fact that how the family has already made several allegations over the jail administration and the government of not taking it seriously has resulted in these reactions.
Yes. Be with us. I'll just come back to you in a moment from now. Abhishek Mishra is outside Mukhtar Ansari's house and Samar Srivastav is at Banda where the postmortem is taking place. The very latest, Samar, the family already said we're not satisfied with what is happening in the government hospital in Uttar Pradesh and that he should be taken to AIIMS in Delhi.
Well, exactly. That's very clear from the family part. Earlier, we saw that that Afzal Ansari, the brother of Mukhtar Ansari, was not satisfied with the medical checkup happening in the Banda Medical College, and he even requested to shift him to the Medanta, Lucknow, and even claimed that he could, the family could even bear the expense of his treatment. But nothing like that happened, and we saw what actually happened yesterday. Mukhtar Ansari died, and now as we got to know that they are demanding the postmortem in the Delhi AIIMS, they are not satisfied with this postmortem that happened in the Banda Degree College. That is the bigger part, though. As per the confirmation, the postmortem has been concluded and the paperwork is going on, and we can expect in the next 15 to 20 minutes the dead body of Mukhtar Ansari could be moved from this medical college to Ghazipur. And you can clearly see that the policemen, the SSB Jawans, have assembled right here, and they are just, and a rope has been put up around that particular premises from where the dead body of Mukhtar Ansari will be taken out and will be put inside the ambulance, and that ambulance will move from this area. And what we've got to know from the sources, they will be taking the Bundelkhand Expressway route in a way to reach at in Ghazipur in some in some lesser time, and what we got to know that in the next 15 to 20 minutes, the dead body of Mukhtar Ansari could be moved from here, and his son Umar Ansari will be there throughout the movement with the police team. And we have also seen the police buses, the SSB Jawan's buses, the vehicles, the police jeeps have already been stationed, and in the next 15 to 20 minutes we can expect the movement from Bandra College.